tricky going from a American game to a Japanese game because the circle and X button are swapped. first save on a memory card takes longer than later ones. Because it has to create the block on the memory card and then save the specific file.
Thank you.
Okay, I think we lost him. Sometimes he can follow me up there. Tried to roll through him. Almost worked. It's not bad. I was supposed to take out the weapon before getting close to him, but I didn't. I ran too quickly. Wait, he did the double. I didn't even know they could do the double on normal. Or let's just... Wait, am I not gonna lose the... I have to take off my disguise to lose the meter faster. Like, how can he see me? I'm in a different room. What is going on? Okay, see, that time it wasn't even my fault. Like, I didn't get the colors mixed up. He did the double thing where it's just... As far as I know, impossible to... Is it possible to... No. I forgot that he would take out the weapon if I did that. I was just trying to sneak. I should be in disguise to do that, though. Sorry. Take it nice and slow. Oh, the meter's already down, that's nice. So I should be able to just do this. Maybe he's standing further away. There we go. Oh, I hate that guy. Like, it's almost worth it just not even try and pick him, or not even, like, fool him. So I can intentionally run past and then come back and do that. is heavy careful. Using too much ammo. camera work there. Almost perfect. Messed up a little bit because I didn't realize I was reloading. Like, still, that was really fast. Like, none of them even got close to me. Nice.
Lupin!
Kinda need to be in disguise there.
Thank you.
He had a good read shooting in that corner. I want to go around that guy in the corner, but he's too far out. So I have to take the hit. I end up getting hit twice for it. That little safe. Sing their instant kill. Instant arrest. It's weird because, like, they can. I'm constantly being surrounded by police officers and not getting arrested. How am I? I was touching a laser. That bad. Like, they know I'm here, right? That makes any sense. I was thinking about using a disguise for the first few seconds to place and he got to appearing, but I just do it how I usually do it.
know. Evan, Duban, Duban, Duban!
What's that guy doing there? Maybe I've ever seen that before. Just a random guy wandering. When I've got everyone else following me. Oh, and two guys, nice. Means I had good movement when I somehow lose everybody except for two of them. Meaningless swings. Dang, that guy took a shortcut. It's not fair. That was bad movement right there. Up against the elevator door, they all freeze for some reason. So as long as they're not already in hitting range, you're good. I meant to change my splits background when I change games. Boink. It was interesting. Lured that guy into that room. Actually, I probably could have just ran over to this guy and talked to him before the cop did anything. That's her equivalent to a roll, but it's because I accidentally pressed X because I was mashing X to get out of the menu. I forgot what her role looks like. It's been, I don't know, a year since I've ever actually used it. For a second, she looked like she wasn't going to aim at him, and that would really bad. If I fired in the wrong direction, she would have just been arrested. That was weirdly nice. Like he just looked at me suspicious both times, even though I was running. The shot again. next one's a right turn. Alright, they didn't catch up to me. That's all that matters. Actually, it would have been a good time, except I press square instead of circle. Because in Treasure the Sorcerer King, you use square to attack, and in this game, you use circle.
Thank you.
turn there. Oh, that door's a little far away. Just gonna grab a safety box. I think one's probably enough, but I'll just grab a second one for some necessary safety. Oh, camera. Position. He can just hit me from there. And the one that should be able to hit me isn't even fine. I've got this guy in a place where he's not even firing. This is off screen. Nice. Wish the camera always cooperated like that. World's greatest security system. Big glowing orange button on the desk. When you press it, a statue-shaped hole appears behind a statue. If you push the statue into the statue-shaped hole, a big panel opens up, revealing the emerald. I just like fired at the ceiling. Ow. Oh, I'm in the red.
団で風通しよくしてやる。
What a fight. The bosses are kind of a joke in this game compared to the previous one. Wait. I don't want that yet. What am I doing? I mean, it would have been fine if I got it. I just would have not got it the next time, but like, I want to do them in order. Right, I guess I should have gotten it because now I'm wasting time by running over there, but whatever. Oh! Oh, what's that? Can you believe I'm big enough to get trolls? It's a big accomplishment. See, by getting the telescope this time, we get the second ending. For 100%, we need all three endings. I do these first two back to back, and then for the third one, we have to start from the beginning. I guess it requires me to get an item right at the beginning. Laser is actually a one shot, so it's actually possible to use the C1 trading. Whereas with every other attack, he can, or rather, I can do more damage than he can, so I win the damage trade. I do want to save.
Yeah.
Now for the fun part. Doing basically the entire game over again from the beginning. See, there's a difference. I picked up that little map, which I need to get the true ending. Not the third ending, anyway. Oh. Hey, Roar. Thanks for the raid. Caught me right smack dab in the middle of a trifecta. sound like Mario. What were you playing? I was watching you earlier. You were playing some open world game. But I didn't see how it ended because I started this stream. You probably finished that a long time ago though. Guessing a SNES Aladdin. Just because that's most popular. I think. Oh, PlayStation. Nice. I don't think I played that one. I'm guessing that one's actually a different game. This game's probably not going to be, quite as exciting. It's sort of the slowest of the three in the trilogy. Although I'm already halfway done with this game. You basically have to play the entire game twice. Alright, thanks for stopping by. Thanks for the raid. Thank you. Hi, Silver Lurker. Yeah, this stream is definitely gonna be chill. I've gotta pace myself for a 10-hour run. And just this game particularly can put you to sleep. See, I'm doing the trifecta, which is all three Lupin games for the PS2, 100%, back to back to back. And I've done the first game, this is the second one. I'm a little over halfway through it. And the third game is about 5.5 hours for 100%. Mostly because it has a ton of unskippable cutscenes. So yeah, there actually are three endings for this game. But that's just for this game. This is the first time anyone's ever done this. In fact, I'm the only one who speedruns all three of these games. Hey, he actually cooperated. Choose to be unfoolable. I have to waste some time running away and coming back. People see, yeah, how much work I put into these games. They'll want to speedrun them too. Maybe.
Summer!
kind of lost confidence trying to get other people to run Lupin games. There were a couple, though. Couple people. Camera's backwards. Yeah, you can't actually control the camera in this game, so sometimes it just decides to face the opposite of how you expect it to face. It's not 100% fixed. Yeah. Yeah, the bad camera in this game is sort of the big complaint that most people have. It's one of the reasons that it's considered to be the worst in the three. This isn't good. Don't miss. I had one bullet left. It's not that bad failing that minigame, you just try again. Just wasted a little bit of time. Yeah, this game had a lot of good ideas when they were making it. And there were a lot of little things that were smart that they improved from the previous game, but there were a lot of things they did wrong and sort of made it a worse game. See, this game particularly, it's not my favorite among them, but it's in the PS2 trilogy, so it sort of gets a free ride with the other games, which are really good. Yeah, the first Treasure of the Sorcerer King is one of my favorite games ever. I played a lot as a kid. And this game is similar to it, it's just not as good. Thank you. Even if a Lupin game were really bad, I would still speedrun it just because I speedrun all of them. But I think they're all pretty good. I think even people who are fans of Lupin the Third haven't necessarily heard of this game. This one was only released in Japan and makes it kind of obscure. So right there I had to choose Goemon because the previous playthrough of the game I chose Jigen. I have to do each of them once for the 100% because you unlock the minigames in the main menu. It's definitely a chill game. Put you to sleep sometimes. Even if you're the one playing it. Run pretty far forward. Yeah, Goemon's known for that. Slicing police cars, helicopters, buildings sometimes, tanks. He's a pretty scary dude. Yes, actually, Lupin is mainly known for the anime. The video games are much lesser known. Of course, also the manga and many, many movies. Started in the 70s, and the latest season was last year, so it's been around a long time. Yeah. Although when people think of Lupin, they think of the anime first, I think. More popular. This poor guy has a very stressful job. We're just gonna borrow these. Yeah, the same way. I've seen a lot more anime than I have read manga. Yeah, I can read some Japanese. I can't really read kanji. Like, I know some, but not really. But, like, I know enough Japanese to route speedruns. Thank you. it took me like a long time to learn hiragana and katakana, like when I was in high school. But then like you try and learn kanji and you realize, oh, that was kana is so simple. Should have taken me like a day to learn that. Easy to forget languages if you don't use them. I've heard of some people actually like losing one of their native languages because they only spoke one language. Seems weird to me. Hey, Megason. You're super late. Decent so far. I mean, you can see how the first game went on the splits. I guess I lost like a minute in that one. And in this one I probably lost at least like a minute or two because of that one guy giving me trouble. Don't worry, even if you're 4 hours late, you've missed less than half of the trifecta. How much did it cost? I've been thinking about getting a PS4 for a long time, but I haven't bothered. I'll wait till the PS5 comes out. And it'll be super cheap, hopefully. Dang. That's a good selection of games. I mean, I've seen some of the promos for that game. It's pretty good. I don't think I saw her in any of the previews. I remember Cloud and Tifa, I think. See, I would use that excuse, but people would say, what about that collection of Fujiko figurines behind you? Probably gonna release on PC at some point, right? Yeah, a year later sounds normal, if not sooner. Problem is, my PC is also terrible, so I couldn't play that anyway. Thank you. be fair, if you're only going to own one in the past 20 years, it's a pretty good choice. As someone who has two PS2s, I'd say it's a pretty good console. Extra stuff to me already, that's weird. I didn't think I had bad movement. GameCube games expensive right now? Yeah, things like SNES and NES and older consoles like that, you can definitely just emulate. Oh, bad movement. Ran right into him. If I have a copy of Earthbound, I don't think I do. I had a bunch of random SNES games as a kid. It's possible that there was an Earthbound like mixed in there. Pretty sure I had Chrono Trigger. still somewhere. Kind of close. I see there's a switch to turn off all these lasers and stuff, but it's faster to just go back through them. Guys, for a short bit in this room. It seems like I'm getting Zenigata appearing consistently in the second room when it used to be like the third room. Slower, but it delays them from seeing me until I get into this room. In fact, if I'd been really good with my timing, I could have taken off this guy and made him lose sight of me. Yes, usually Zenigata appears in that second room. He still hasn't appeared in this third room. Maybe he's just like not gonna appear. What is happening? I haven't seen that in a long time. He just waited that out. Interesting, because he didn't appear, I got an extra cutscene of him appearing. I Oh yeah, I did see that clip, I believe. Yeah, it's like, wait, what am I? Remember Zenigata in the back of the police car? Guess he probably had Lupin in there with him, I don't remember. But yeah, I did see that. I mean, at this point, I just want to see the movie. Previous floor without him appearing. He just appears anyway. I have a terrible memory. I remember it looked really good. Goemon slice some stuff. Actually, you know why I don't remember it very well? There's no Fujiko in it. It's just these three goons and Zenigata. Minutes for the first game, about 3.5 hours for the second game, and about 5.5 hours for the last game. So really it could be like 5 hours and 20 minutes, but you know, chances are there are going to be mistakes doing three runs back to back to back, and also there's time in between the games. Prison of the Past is already downloadable. I haven't downloaded it. Supposedly fan subbers are slow with the Lupin movies. Probably just watch it without subtitles. First time. Wait, what? Wait, what do you mean? They did? They release it with subtitles? What do you mean? That seems surprising. It just aired on like the 29th. Were you talking about the other one? Goodbye Partner? Seen that however long ago. Yeah, I saw the Edward Snowden tweet. That was kind of funny. You've seen the movie, right? Like, he's in it. It's kind of funny that he would. What is that? Oh, alright. I was so confused. I was trying to punch this guy and I accidentally talked to that guy again. Like, I didn't even need to punch that guy. That was silly. If you're not gonna get betrayed by Fujiko, why even be in the movie? Why get out of bed? rather they just make a game based on the movie, but they probably won't do that. Two figures, though, that's nice. I might get both of them, even though only one of them is Fujiko. It's kind of dangerous if they do, because then I'll have to buy the console it's on if it's not Switch, or if it's PC, then I probably have to buy a better graphics card. Let us stand there, their arms crossed. I see you punched out that police officer right in front of me. Interesting. Like this woman. She doesn't approve, but she won't stop me. For now. I see, usually I wouldn't think they would make like a big game. It would be like, you know, something small and cute, like a puzzle game or something. But they've been pushing the movie pretty hard. Seems like every day there's a new cross promotion with some other brand or something. I didn't even know Steam could have region-locked games. I don't really use Steam, though. Sunday. I've basically played all the other games multiple times in that series, but since I don't have a PS4, I never played Kingdom Hearts 3. Otherwise, I would have gotten it like day one. Yeah, there have been a lot of intermediate titles. I think the biggest one that you would want to have played is Birth by Sleep. I don't know if the other one's quite... and Dream Drop Distance. But even that one... Why do I keep thinking that's a right turn? This one's the right turn. I feel like they probably made it so you won't be totally lost if you haven't played. I mean, you'll be lost if you haven't played the first two, but other than that, it's probably not too confusing. At least not more than usual. Minutes, that's pretty fast. Yeah, that's good enough. It's like reviewing all the material in a world history class in 15 minutes. Weird, it looked like I could have swung like a second earlier, but like I was pressing circle. This game's weird. Nah, it's all right. I don't mind talking about random stuff. Especially for this game where there's, you know, plenty of time to talk and not even really that much to explain, even if I wanted to explain everything that was going on. Actually, I mean, I guess there's a lot of plot and story going on in this game, but gameplay is pretty straightforward. Thank you. That kick. Actually, wasn't I at like one health? How did that guy not kill me with that kick? Interesting. I guess I had a chunk of red left. I'm gonna die here though. I think if they get around the first corner before I get around the second corner, then they'll make it around the second corner. Yeah, see, there it is. Camera all over the place. Alright, we're good. I feel like I've been taking a lot of damage, so I'm gonna grab both of these. I think optimally in a normal run I wouldn't grab either of these, but don't want to blow a 100% run during a trifecta. Somehow they were all able to hit me from there. Like, how was that thing not blocking me a little bit? It's a good thing I grabbed all that health. That was like as bad as that fight could have gone. I don't know how all three of them could hit me there. I feel like I should have been pretty well covered by that thing. Thank you. I don't know how much Witcher 3 usually costs, but that does sound like a good deal. Yeah, I've never played that game either, but I've heard a lot of people give it a lot of praise. Like it's the greatest game ever. I feel like Witcher 3 is the one I've heard the most about. Like, I'm not sure if I've even heard of the series before Witcher 3 came out. Talk to that door. I actually bought that game. The GameCube game. I don't have a Japanese Wii or GameCube. I'm gonna figure out how to play it. Either buy one of those or find out if I can somehow make one of my consoles region free. Is that the best Lupin game to run? It is if you like watching movies instead of playing video games. Hey, they didn't see me. As far as I can tell, it's basically totally random whether or not they see me immediately or if I actually get them on screen like usual, like most enemies. Yes, that's what I don't know about. Can you play Japanese GameCube games on it? Another thing, if there is a way around, will I be able to do a multi-disc game? Because I think Umi ni Kieta Hiho has two discs. So it has to be a solution that like totally works. I think I still have my GameCube somewhere. I haven't seen it in like 10 years. I think it's somewhere in this house. Somewhere. Packed among all my stuff. I think there's like a mod you can do to make it region free. Which is pretty simple. For a second, I was about to accidentally press circle and choose Jigen, mess up the whole run. In this game are so intense. Resident Sleeper. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I think I've seen one where it's like a describe. There's like a thing on the motherboard. It's just like says whether it's a NA or JP GameCube, and you can like solder in a switch, like not even like a custom part, just any switch, and to switch between the two modes. Yeah, I have a soldering iron, so I mean. It looked like a pretty simple thing to install. Although, like, I don't know, I guess I can order like a Switch online. I'm trying to think like what store, like physical store has electronic components, I don't even know. I feel like a hardware store might have stuff like that for stuff. Yeah, it would be easier just to install a switch, right? Than just plug it whenever I need to switch modes. Let's get that third ending. Swapping from old consoles. Speaking of which, I'm going to swap a disc in a minute. Far enough away, fires over. Yeah. that's the only save I need, right? Yeah. Disc, come out. Come out and play disc. I like how this is still running while I'm swapping discs.